A one, two, three, four.
Well, I busted flat in Baton Rouge, heading for the train, feeling nearly faded as my jeans. Old Bobby thumbed the diesel down just before it rained. Lord, took us all the way to New Orleans. Pulled my old harpoon out of my dirty red bandana.
We're at Taupo now for the annual Rotary Club Stress Weekend, and it's a wonderful weekend. It's been going now for over 40 years. And why are we doing it, and why are we here? Peter Sugden's the man with all the answers. Peter,
well, Warren,
what's the Stress Weekend, Peter?
Well, Warren, within our club, we thought it was time that the members got together in a social way and come up to Taupo. And get the stress off them by playing golf or going fishing.
Peter, I've seen the result of these stress weekends, and most of the guys coming back are far more stressed than when they left.
Well, yes, a lot of the problems have been self-inflicted over the years each, but we don't learn from our experiences, and we still come up every year. I think the person probably to give you more information on the history of the very early days, of course, is Ron Ward, because Ron Ward and Jack Lockyer.
Trips to Taupo originally were fishing trips. Jack Lockyer, who was then the club treasurer, and I, who was club secretary, both had batches and boats up at Taupo, and on regular weekends we used to go up there fishing. And we decided at some stage in the late 60s that we'd invite a couple of our Rotary members to come up with us. And they did, and stayed with us, and then came fishing with us and thoroughly enjoyed it. On one occasion, in one of the motels, we had one of our past presidents, Ted Walker, with us. It was a particularly good fishing weekend, and I remember it well because Tom McDonald came with Jack Lockyer and me. And Jack and I were determined that Tom would get his limit. The limit in those days was 8 trout, and Tom, we made sure Tom got his, and he actually had his limit before lunch.
Probably one of the great experiences I had in Taradale Rotary was when we took him to Taupo for our annual stress seminar. Being charter president, he'd never ever been to a stress seminar, so I picked him up. We travelled to Taupo. The next day, Tom went out fishing and caught the limit, which was a great thrill for him. And he'd taken up a dozen bottles of his best wine, and I can assure you, we had a great night that night.
Yes, my recollection of the very first one was we stayed at the Link Motels, which were opposite the golf club, and I think the president of the Taupo Rotary Club owned those motels, and that's why we stayed there, and we were supposed to get together with them, but that was a bit of a disaster really. I think they thought they were a bit superior to the Taradale Rotary Club, and all we did was play golf against them. And I was saying that the fellow I struck was the president of the Taupo Club and was on a 1 handicap. I don't think he particularly liked having to play with me on a 24 or 25. Proceeded to just about drive the first green while I tipped mine over the bank into the hollow in front. And at the moment, we all sat round and had drinks that first night, and they had a rip-roaring party down at the motel headquarters and didn't even invite us. So that was the end of getting together with the Taupo Rotary Club. From then on, we just did it individually.
In the early days when we arrived, we'd stay at the spa, up the spa road at the back of the clubhouse, which was in the spa road at the Taupo golf course. And from there we'd go to our various missions during the weekend and then meet up again in the evenings.
The thing developed further as other people in our club brought their boats up, and it became a regular yearly event. It was not called the Stress Seminar until a later date.
Now, our intrepid members, an accountant called Bill Stewart, decided that it should be called a Stress Seminar, and then those of us that were in business could claim it back off their tax. And we all thought that was a great idea, and my accountant, Jim McIver, had no reason to think that it shouldn't be done. So from then on, the stress seminar was paid for by the business.
To the Rangitai, where we got on the pool table, and Kel and I sort of seemed to have a pretty good trot. And we were there, heaven knows what time we left there, and probably shouldn't have been driving on to Taupo, but did, and took us 7 hours. And that was, we got the record for the long drive.
A one, two, three, four. Well, I busted flat in Baton Rouge, heading for the train, feeling nearly faded as my jeans. Old Bobby thumbed the diesel down just before it rang. Lord, took us all the way to New Orleans. Pulled my old harpoon out of my dirty red bandana. Blowing low while Bobby sang the blues. With them windshield wipers slapping time and Bobby clapping hands mine. We finally sang up of a song that driver knew. Feeling it's another world, but nothing left to lose, and nothing ain't worth nothing but it's free. Feeling good was easy, Lord, when Bobby sang the blues. Lord, that was good enough for me. Yeah, good enough for me and Bobby McGee. From a little coal mine of Kentucky to the California sun, Bobby shared the secrets of my soul. She was standing around the sun, the Lord knew everything he'd done. And every night she kept me from the cold.
How many
have we got? How many have we got?
Three.
You're handsome. Everybody's behaving themselves. What does it look like? There you go.
Still bloody swimming, Jack. That's enough.
Kevin, is one up there coming down?
I know. We were safe tonight. It's Mr. Aitken running around the place looking as handsome as ever. Sorry about that. Yeah. Get prepared. That's true.
Lord, that was good enough.
What does it look like?
Just waking up.
Close to mine.